is ravaging the universe, affecting all life as we know it! How will our heroes solve a dimensional cataclysm?
Oh my.
Hi everyone, my name is Jeff Haynes, Senior Editor of Video Games at Common Sense Media, and I'm here today with a quick look at Ratchet & Clank Rift Apart. It's an action-adventure game that was released exclusively for the PlayStation 5 on June 11th, 2021. Now, we've gone out of our way to try to avoid some story spoilers and major plot points because we think that this is a game you and your family will really enjoy exploring and diving into on your own. But we thought we'd give you a really quick sense of the start of the game just so that you have an idea of the setting and the universe that this particular franchise is set in. Now, the Ratchet & Clank franchise has been around since the PlayStation 2 days, and it basically set up a situation where aliens and robots live together in some kind of harmony, or I guess disharmony, if you will, especially if you go off of the dystopian setting that you see right here on screen. It always starred Ratchet, which is basically known as the last Lombax in the galaxy. He and his friend Clank, who happened to be a very small robot, would find themselves facing off against Dr. Nefarious, an evil robotic overlord that wanted to take over the galaxy and rule everything within his iron clutches. Now, of course, as you can see here, this particular alien or Lombax, as you see, seems to be stealing a robot and running it away from its patrol that it happens to be in, thereby sending that patrol on a frantic search for the kidnapped bot. I'm going to skip past that a little bit because obviously it seems like Ratchet may be doing something a little bit shady here and there. We'll get back to that probably as you explore the entire game. But we're going to hop a little bit farther ahead to where Ratchet and Clank are being celebrated by the aliens of this particular world for their deeds as heroes in stopping Dr. Nefarious. This is a great way of introducing players to some of the actions from some of the previous games, especially if they haven't played them yet. Of course, that's just a really quick snippet and taste. In many ways, it doesn't really give you the full sense. And of course, just like every other bad villain in every other movie franchise or game franchise, you really can't keep them down. Dr. Nefarious winds up popping up at the parade and interrupting the proceedings, stealing a tool that's known as a Dimensionator, and of course, causing a certain amount of distraction by sending a lot of armed guards to try to eliminate Ratchet and Clank so that he can move forward with his own particular scheme. As you can see, one of the things that he's planning on doing is using the Dimensionator to open up rifts in space and time, thereby undoing some of the work that Ratchet and Clank have done, and essentially having a new scheme of his come to fruition. Of course, to stop him, Ratchet and Clank are going to need a new arsenal, a lot of guns and a lot of hardware. That's where this Mrs. Zircon kiosk comes in, where the shots that you see on screen right here are kind of giving you a humorous glimpse of what exactly the hardware is going to be. This is basically one of the only sticking points that you might have, which is the violence, which is cartoonish in nature. In many ways, you'll use a wrench to defeat enemies in hand-to-hand combat, but you'll use certain things like that Enforcer, which is a shotgun-like weapon, or a burst pistol, which is a pistol, a rapid-fire pistol, or even grenade-style projectiles to defeat aliens and robots alike. No blood or gore is ever shown, and in fact, the only thing that actually does pop up are bolts, which happens to be the currency of this particular galaxy, which can then be redeemed for additional hardware, additional ammo, and also upgrades as well. Now, if you have any other questions or concerns about the content that happens to be found within Ratchet & Clank Rift Apart or any other game, you can always check out our reviews on commonsensemedia.org, where we have full information and breakdowns of what you can find and what you can expect in every single title that we cover. But let's get back to the action right here. As you can see, a gunfight has actually broken out in the middle of this park, and we're taking out a lot of our enemies, thereby gaining some of those bolts that I just mentioned, allowing us to then go to a different kiosk and get a new weapon. One of the other parts about combat, of course, because there are a lot of frequent sequences where you'll be fighting off a lot of guards or a lot of enemies, is that you'll use that to level up and improve Ratchet's abilities and stats. One of the important things, of course, as you're facing off against some of these enemies and gaining the bolts, is you're basically strengthening Ratchet so that he can actually take on more enemies and survive longer in a lot of the fights, because you will be attacked frequently from a lot of different directions. Of course, the more mayhem and more destruction you wind up causing, as you can see right here, the easier it will be for you to level up, thereby gaining additional health and a little extra power for attacking in battle. Of course, you can also level up your weapons too, and we'll get to that in a little bit. Let's move a little bit farther ahead, because of course, we've managed to temporarily stop Dr. Nefarious, but again, he's not going to be inconvenienced just at the beginning of the game, or even with one scheme. He's got plenty of them, and he wants to set all of them in motion. He winds up opening a rift and leaping through it, and he also sucks you into a rift as well. That gives you kind of a sense of some of the gameplay that you'll be exploring and experiencing throughout this entire game, where you're going to be hopping across different worlds, different platforms, even through different dimensional spaces on the same level, simply to explore and figure out ways of getting past some of the enemies that you're going to be fighting against. And this is really kind of a nice snapshot of what kind of chaos Dr. Nefarious has caused. As you can even see, the robot that he happened to be on goes flying from one building to the next. And you even went being propelled into completely different circumstances. In fact, right here, as Ratchet and Clank happen to be on this pirate ship that's being attacked by some kind of kraken or some kind of odd creature, even they're not safe. They get propelled through another void, they get separated, and that also causes another aspect of the game where you're going to have to try to figure out a way of not only reuniting with your friend, but also defeating Nefarious, even using some of those rifts that I mentioned to figure out other ways of getting around areas. Now, of course, to do that, like I said, you're going to need your arsenal to work. You're also going to have to find new allies. The arsenal is going to come into effect, especially right here, where your enemies are going to come at you from all sides. And it's really going to be important for you to figure out exactly what the best tool for the job happens to be at that particular situation. As you can see, pulling up some of the weapons or the weapon wheel to figure out what you have. Sometimes you want to find out, hey, I have all of these enemies coming at me quickly. I need something that will give me rapid fire, or I'm in a very enclosed space. Maybe I need something that will cause a lot of damage in one area. Whichever one you use, as you can see right there, the more you use a weapon, the stronger it becomes. And you can level up the weapons, thereby gaining new abilities, new effects, and strengthening them for the fights ahead. But I also mentioned that you're going to need new allies. This happens to be one of Ratchet's new allies, and its name is Glitch, which happens to be a program that Ratchet will use to unlock certain equipment that he'll come across that happens to be locked up or password protected or even blocked from regular access. Of course, this winds up kind of triggering a little mini game within the game itself, where you take control of Glitch, and she goes into the systems trying to figure out what the problem happens to be. Now, of course, unfortunately for Glitch, she thinks that she's only going to be deleting a couple files, maybe repairing a few circuits, but there's a lot more going on. In fact, as she goes into this particular system, she finds out that there are a lot of viruses that happen to be inside the machine. Fortunately, she has the equipment that she can use to clear out the infection, but as you move through the plot, not only with Ratchet and with Glitch, you'll discover that there's a lot more going on inside some of the equipment, and it'll be up to Glitch, and only Glitch, to clear out some of these things, but also figure out a way of stopping some of the insidious viruses that seem to be infecting a lot of machines all across the universe. Now, we're going to hop ahead a little bit more, only because you're not only going to play as Ratchet within Rift Apart. One of the interesting things is that for the first time in the franchise's history, you're actually going to play as another Lombax, and that other Lombax is known as Rivet. Now, it kind of makes a little bit of sense because, of course, if you're moving through alternate dimensions, maybe you might stumble upon alternate versions of yourself. Well, arguably, Rivet is Ratchet's alternate dimensional self. There are a few minor differences. For instance, Rivet has a hammer instead of a wrench, but much of the gameplay, much of the elements, much of the effects are exactly the same. In fact, as you're going through sequences and you're using your weapons to level them up and upgrade and become stronger, Rivet will have access to those improved weapons and vice versa. Now, you won't be able to pick and choose exactly which character you'll use on different planets. They're all tied together in very specific plot points, and there's there's a reason why you'll use one character on a certain planet or in a certain sequence versus another. But that all plays out. I'm not going to spoil that here. That's definitely something that you'll want to experience and figure out for yourself. But it is nice to know that in many ways you're not losing any progress. In fact, it also makes it more important for you to gain a lot more progress with the weapons that you get access to. Of course, you're not always going to be fighting against other aliens or robots or other things. For instance, right here, you have what's called a speedle race, where Rivet is on the back of this very quick beetle-like creature as it is moving through the acidic swamps of Sargasso, which happens to be Rivet's home planet. The reason why she's doing this is because Clank has been kidnapped by that floating robot known as a Secrepede and is trying to escape, and of course she wants to get Clank back as quickly as possible. So she hops on the back of this bug so that she can basically chase it down. There are a lot of sequences like this within the game, which really manages to vary up a lot of the gameplay, keeps it fresh, keeps it exciting, because there are a lot of races, there are a couple different fights and arenas that you'll wind up floating your way through, there are rifts that you'll jump through, there are even places where you'll be messing around with the gravity of a location, which really keeps you on your toes in some cases. So it really it makes everything exciting. It also means that here and there are different places where you'll face off against bosses or even mini bosses as you're going across every single section, every single planet. So you can not only use those fights to gain additional experience, but it also kind of makes the gameplay different. It makes sure that you're never actually experiencing the same thing over and over again. Of course, one of the other things about the Ratchet and Clank franchise that has always stood out and stood the test of time across all of the games and the movie itself that was released for the Ratchet and Clank franchise are the wacky weapons and guns. For instance, right here, as you can see, there's this thing called the topiary sprinkler, which turns the enemies that it sprays into lawn decorations, which you can then run up to and use your wrench or your hammer to cause a lot of significant damage to those frozen in place creatures. It also gives you the opportunity, like that right there, to see somewhat unintentionally funny poses that some of the creatures can find themselves stuck into. Whether it happens to be the historically accurate wacky weapon of the Sheepinator, which turned enemies into sheep, or the specific weapons in this game, like the topiary sprinkler, or say the rhino, which can drop characters and buses from alternate dimensions on enemies' heads. There's a lot of very strange things. There's even something called the cold blast, where you can freeze somebody in a block of ice and then use the shards from the broken blocks of ice to cause damage on any surrounding enemy that happens to be nearby. It's very much tongue-in-cheek when you're fighting a lot of the enemies, but it also happens to show off a lot of the firepower of the PlayStation 5 itself, because it can demonstrate not only how vast and expansive the creatures happen to be, but it can also show off a lot of the destructive effects when you're fighting in the middle of battle and having a lot of bolts and shards and shrapnel fly up and spray everywhere in the environment. So we're coming up on the tail end of this video, but I wanted to showcase one thing that's always been very key to the Ratchet & Clank franchise, and those are battle arenas. Now, battle arenas are very important because not only are they places where you can gain a lot of bolts to then upgrade your weapons, but it's also a place where you can practice with a newly acquired weapon or upgraded weapon to see what the effects are, so you know exactly what you can use on a separate mission or in battle by and of itself. It's really, really important. It's always fun. In fact, as you can see right there, that robot had managed to hit Rivet with its sword, then pulled out a selfie stick and took a selfie. So you have a sense that it's always going to be tongue-in-cheek, very wacky, very interesting, but always you know, in keeping with the franchise's humor and action-paced gameplay. That's a really quick look at Ratchet & Clank Rift Apart, as I said, released exclusively on the PlayStation 5 on June 11th, 2021. For more top picks and advice to fit your family, be sure to check out commonsensemedia.org.